Hi, welcome to a quick demo of iBeams, a interactive effects system and music visualizer for the iPhone. Initially, iBeams boots up. It's very simple, lightning bolt. You don't think it can do that much, but actually it can do a ton. I'm pulling up the iBeam core effects list. So besides lightning bolt, we've got squiggles, flames, lasers. There's 15 different core effects. They do different things using different mathematical functions that typically start at a source point and a target point. The source point is over here, the target point's over here. You can have up to 5 target points, also known as your fingertips. On the right, we've got girders, which are the saved settings. When you build something cool with iBeams, you can save the girders. And this is a couple of pre-built examples. You'll see there's a green circle that's actually a music volume indicator, because you can make iBeams turn into a little music visualizer. So this is actually the symmetry mode. Right now there's one mirror, so what's on the right side is being reflected onto the left side. The volume of my voice is actually affecting how the zoom parameter. And let's go and take a look at some of those parameters. Hit reset, just set everything back to zero, initial conditions. This is the first page of parameters. There's lots of stuff, lots of options. Changing the speed, changing the number of beams, changing the width, changing how noisy the effects are. If I double click, it switches what core effect it's going to use, or double tap in this case. And you'll notice there's a blue ball, which you can hide on the second page, but it lets you move around the emitter. I'm going to crank up the echoes, and you'll notice how everything sort of is staying permanently on the screen now. The motion blur is sort of permanent, and I'm going to adjust the zoom. You see the little grid shows how things get distorted over time. So now things are being spun. And we've got this cool little fractal pattern. So that's a different rendering setting. You can turn on the accelerometer, and depending on how you tilt the device, the echoes will move accordingly. Now, I mentioned you can hear my voice and it's reacting. That works for music too. I'm gonna start a little. Start some audio here, and I'm going to hook up one of these parameters to the music. Each one of these is a button that pulls up how you want to control it, and you can control it with by pinching and zooming. But you can also set it up so that it responds to the microphone and adjust the strength of that. So that's the zoom being attached to the microphone. I can also go and change how the spin value is being interpreted right now. It's just doing whatever is happening over here. But I could also go and say, use the microphone, or a sine wave, or just a random value that changes every couple of seconds. I'm gonna leave it as a sine wave. This lets you adjust how long it'll take to go from the oscillate from the lowest value to the highest value. So that's some of those parameters on the front page, and the idea that you can actually build your own little music visualizer with these controller framework. Adjust the texture map that we're using. some of the effects display those better than others. If I turn off glowy rendering instead of everything adding together and getting super bright, the colors just sort of merge together and overlay each other a little bit more naturally. So that's a different rendering option. And some of these texture maps look better with glowy, and some of them look better with non-glowy. We adjust the background color. And I can create more sources and more targets. Can make them invisible so the blue ball is gone. I can make another blue ball. I'm going to add a permanent target in case my fingers get tired. So now the swarm is going after the red dot. So you can construct some interesting effect, interesting designs this way. Move these around. And just going to erase them. The last thing I'm going to show off is the echo page. This is just for editing the distortion. So the echo, zoom, and spin are duplicated here, but there's also kaleidoscope controls. So the little white box is indicating which part of the screen is being used as the source of the kaleidoscope. I can have up to 32 mirrors. I can also have other cool distortion effects, warp the whole thing onto a sphere. Non-uniformly scale X and Y separately. And the tack options make things stick to the edges a little bit more. So symmetry goes away, but there's some other cool aspects to it. Oopsie. Yeah, that doesn't look great. Oh, that's cool. So it's warping along the edges because of that tack option. There's even more parameters, but the music's over, and I think you've listened enough. Thanks.